Ladies and gentlemen, this is the WBO European Lightweight Championship. Please welcome into the ring the challenger from Glasgow, Scott Harrison!
Yeah. This house party is crazy. My crew is hella wavy. Yo, click the cup, then say what's up, then slide out with your lady.
Here he is, Scott Harrison, now 35 years old. A long way away from home, and it's fair to say not getting a particularly enthusiastic welcome, but I'm sure there are going to be thousands watching up in Scotland who'll be hoping that Scott can regain some of the form that carried him right to the top not so long ago. It's a fascinating one, this, because once upon a time you'd have said, yeah, Scott Harrison would just blow Liam Walsh away, but now, of course, because of everything that's happened, there are those question marks. Tonight we'll see.
Yeah, most definitely, and you've hit the nail on the head there. It's what Scott Harrison did we get tonight? That's what you don't know. Those years out of the ring, the way he's lived his life. No, he's cleaned up his act now, and I think he's dedicated himself. But all those years of messing around, will they take their toll?
Certainly looks good. Next, it's Liam Walsh.
Please welcome into the ring the WBO European Lightweight Champion from Cromer, England, Liam Walsh!
Chenzo, where are you at? Hey, how are you doing, Dom? I'm home. Actually, I'm on my way to pick you up. Okay, great. I'm waiting for you. See you then. Bye.
Liam Walsh making his re-entrance with his boxing brothers alongside him. Hasn't fought himself since last July at Upton Park. He had been cancelled in for a world title shot against Ricky Burns, but had a car accident in December, so that didn't happen. Now he makes his ring return, knowing, I think, that he can't afford any sort of slip-up against a man who many people would see as somebody a long way past his best. It's an interesting one, this. Is Walsh going to prosper? Will he move on? Or will Harrison somehow reach back into time and find another great performance?
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren, sponsored by Betfred and Raynham Steel, proudly presents 10 three-minute rounds for the WBO European Lightweight Championship here from Wembley Arena. Your officials are appointed by the World Boxing Organization and the British Boxing Board of Control. Your three scoring judges at ringside are Mr. Zoltán Enyedi of Hungary, Mr. Denny Nelson of the USA, and Mr. Mark Nelson of the USA. Your WBO supervisor is István Koko Kovács of Hungary, and your British Boxing Board of Control representative is Mr. Dave Roden. Your timekeeper at the bell is Michael McCann. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Mr. Frank Michael Mass of Germany. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner, the challenger for the title. He brings with him a record of 27 wins, 2 losses, 2 draws, with 15 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 9 stone, 8 pounds, 8 ounces. That's 134 and a half pounds for our US viewers. And tonight, he wears the black and white shorts. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a former world champion from Glasgow, Scotland, Scott Harrison! And across the ring in the blue corner stands the champion with an unbeaten record of 13 wins with 10 knockouts to his name. at yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 9 stone, 8 pounds, 8 ounces, 134 and a half pounds. And tonight he wears the white and red shorts. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing the WBO European Lightweight Champion from Cromer, Liam Walsh. Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Clean fight, you know the rules, tough shots, and good luck, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, 10 3-minute rounds for the WBO European Lightweight Championship.
Liam Walsh, slightly the taller man, but here's Scott Harrison. Always did look old beyond his years. I guess that his age now is pretty much catching up with the face, but he certainly looks in great shape. Whatever you look at him, and he has got himself into terrific nick for this.
He looks absolutely massive, doesn't he? Look at the size on his back, John. It's huge. So Walsh is going to have to be plenty mobile, as we suspected anyway.
Had two comeback fights, Scott Harrison. Seen them both against a pretty much overmatched Hungarian teenager in his first fight. Had a fairly easy win then against Joe Elford. He looked a little bit poor on that occasion, but he went into the ring at 10 stone 5, Scott Harrison. And he didn't look to me particularly motivated. Well, all the motivation that he could possibly need is going to be there tonight. That's a nice right hand, and he's into range straight away. Walsh, a bit of kidology saying, is that it? But I tell you what, they got through and they landed well.
Yeah, we know Walsh is tough from the Appleby fight, don't we? How tremendously brave he was in that fight to come back and win. But I think Walsh had quite a bright start, took a good left hook there, but he landed with a good left hook pretty much in the first second of the first round. But needs to keep busy with his punches to keep Harrison away.
Harrison was a very, very good fighter back in the day. Beat 6 former world champions. He's got them all on his resume. That's a nice left hand from Walsh. Harrison's chin being called to account in the early stages. I suppose there are parallels with Harrison's comeback with Ricky Hatton's.
And it looks a cut there over the right eye of Walsh. I think that was a clash of heads, I think.
May have been a clash of heads. It'd be interesting to see if the referee calls that one. I don't think it's a bad one. We'll see more clearly at the end of the round.
But not ideal, is it, in the first round against a strong come-forward fighter like Harrison to be already cut and marked up. But for the best part, I think Walsh has boxed okay.
Had to really dig deep, didn't he, in beating Paul Appleby, who was on the floor. Won by 10th round stoppage eventually. Terrific fight that was, which we brought to you from the York Hall. Wary sort of opening from Harrison. Beat him to the punch there with the right hand, Walsh.
Yeah, good movement there by Walsh, wasn't it? Just moving off the hook, spinning off with the hook. And you can see Harrison can, he wants to get close enough to get that right hand into play.
Liam Walsh, immensely popular in Norfolk. Saw another great Norfolk hero, John Thaxton, carried the belt into the ring. Trained by Graham Everett and part of the Farmy Army from Cromer. And the fans are down here in force as ever. Well, the injury's around the right eye, and we'll try and get a really close look at that for you between rounds so you can see for yourself just how bad the damage is.
Yeah, good right hand there, just while you were talking, John, from Walsh.
Well, he's got Mick Williamson in his corner, I think. And there he is, straight away, through the ropes. Well, there's the left hand, there's the head. Do we reckon that's where it came?
Yeah, just both of them committing themselves, weren't they? There we go, nothing intentional about that. Harrison doing the right thing, staying low, looking to work.
Walsh take that opening round for you, Barry?
Yeah, he did for me. I just think the slightly cleaner work, and Harrison landed with a few shots, so he'd be encouraged by that.
Well, Nick Williamson, of course, was the man who kept Ricky Hatton there against another guy in the corner, John Thaxton. Well, goodness knows how he managed to get Hatton through that fight, but he did. So if there's one man who knows his onions, it is Mick.
Second out, round two.
Into the second of a 12-round fight for the WBO European lightweight title. And an interesting fight this is now, with Walsh cut as a result of the head clash in the opening round.
And that's where Walsh doesn't want to be, with his back on the rope. And you let Harrison tee off on you, he loves that, doesn't he? That's really well.
Oh, good shot, good shot from Walsh. Lovely right uppercut. Harrison takes it well and has to go toe-to-toe with Walsh, who feels that he might have rocked him there with that right hand. And the referee, well, now he's going to stand for no nonsense, Mr. Mass. The German referee is laying down the law.
Well, he was Harrison so fired up, isn't he, so focused, that I genuinely think he didn't hear the referee. But he wants a brawl in there tonight, doesn't he? But a lovely delivered uppercut, and again there from Walsh.
This is where Harrison likes it, likes to get inside, likes to land those hooks. If it goes long, you wonder whether or not he's going to have the stamina to carry it right through. Only time will tell on that one.
Yeah, but he's a methodical worker, isn't he, though, Harrison? He likes to wear you down, beat you up.
Peter Harrison, his father, in the corner, along with Jimmy Tibbs. Oh, good shot from Harrison. Nice left hand.
And just prior to that, Walsh landed with a good right uppercut. Good work so far by both fighters.
Well, defence doesn't seem to be of the greatest, but there's some quality shots landed already in this fight. And those who suggested that Harrison is washed up, maybe the old guy's already doing enough to show that he's got something left.
Just have to take another good left hook there from Walsh. And that's what Walsh needs to do. He needs to flick that jab out constantly, I think.
Good balance, Walsh. Good on his feet. Harrison getting right into his face, where he wants to be. Once, twice, bringing up the right uppercut as he drags Walsh on, and the referee again speaking to him. I think one more and he's going to start deducting points.
Well, the fight's been played out the way Harrison, you think Harrison would want it, but Walsh is having more success than you would suspect, isn't he, up close, with that uppercut and catching Harrison coming in with hooks again there, flurrying with some body shots.
Real interesting second round, this one. Both men having their moments. Kidology again from Walsh. Almost invariably, in my experience, when fighters do that, it means that they have felt the weight of the opponent's punch.
Yeah, but I genuinely think he's a cocky kid, isn't he, by nature? And for me, a very close round, but I just edged Walsh. I think that uppercut and a couple of hooks and caught Harrison coming in. But another close one, John.
Well, maybe so. If it went the other way, you wouldn't necessarily be surprised. Here's Peter Harrison with Scott in that corner. There's that uppercut. Look how well Harrison takes it, though, and came back.
Well, Harrison was never, his chin was never a worry, was it, with Scott Harrison? And then he goes there, just so fired up, not happy that he had to take a good shot there. Look at that, beautifully timed there, John.
But he came back from that, Harrison, and landed a terrific left hook of his own.
He did, yeah, had some thudding right hands over the top as well. And he worked the body well, didn't he, Harrison, in that round. But I think he's finding Walsh slightly stronger than what he would suspect.
There's the work on the eye with Mick Williamson, the bearded cuts man. He's a taxi driver by trade. So two rounds gone. Barry Jones giving them both to Liam Walsh. Scott Harrison certainly had his moments, though, in the second round, and I think that was a close round. Maybe that wouldn't be unanimously going in Walsh's direction.
No, I wouldn't have argued if it went the other way, to be honest. I just...
Almost dipped down there.
Yeah, just off
balance, I think, as much as anything. Walsh straight onto him, though, trying to capitalise. Back comes Harrison. Walsh if he could choose, would surely try and keep this long.
Yeah, he's standing his ground more than I thought he would, especially this early stage in the fight. I thought he would have been plenty mobile, using his natural boxing ability, but he's had some good success with it. You just wonder whether the physical strength of Harrison might tire him out. He has to be careful of that.
Not too much between them physically. I mean, Scott Harrison was always a huge featherweight, wasn't he? And Liam Walsh, he's been a super featherweight for most of his professional career. Here they are fighting at lightweight, and Walsh, though, very much the slickster in there. We've seen a bit of switch hitting from him already in this contest.
Yeah, he's done that from the offset. He had to take a good left hook there from Harrison, but yeah, Walsh likes to switch, doesn't he, constantly.
Solid body shot from Harrison.
So Walsh needs to be feinting now, try and draw the leader, Harrison. You'd just like to see a little bit more head movement, wouldn't you, from Scott Harrison when he comes forward.
Quiet around this one, Barry.
You can't blame McKinney. The first two rounds were pretty hectic.
Harrison perhaps just a wee bit wary. That's a nice quality right hand, though, from Harrison. Having to eat a fair few of these jabs, though, from Walsh now. Though he's able to fight at range. And Harrison's face is starting to redden up a little bit.
Yeah, just the punch output of Walsh has slowed down a bit. I think it's given Harrison a little bit more success, had a chance to get a little bit closer to Walsh. Just lands him a glancing left hook there, wasn't it, from Harrison?
It wasn't far away. And Walsh knew it. There was a wry little smile that he gave to Harrison just after it had just flicked the edge of his chin.
But a better round for Harrison for me, this. Again, not much in it, but I just think he's been the aggressor. Landed with some there again, some decent jabs.
Nice body shot from Harrison, and a little nod from Harrison to Walsh this time at the end of the round. Here's Peter Harrison, his father, with the former world champion.
Is it gone over a little bit? Thanks, Jesse. I said the jab, what did I do that?
Right.
Go again. Right. You don't want him keeping you up, Scott, right?
Right.
He's playing long distance, trying to keep you up.
Yeah, so
you're catching him.
You're catching him.
You get a double jab, get yourself in there. Nice take combination. Right. Body head, once again, okay.
Right hand, double jab is your dead center, right hand.
I guess you're up.
Put it for an angle, but just from under.
Looking good.
Jimmy Tibbs there as well. Fair few years of experience between them.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Jab, I guess. You give Harrison that last round?
Yes, I did, John. I think he had much more success than Walsh. And Walsh just took his foot off the gas slightly.
A chance of Farmy Army go up, trying to inspire Walsh as he lands with that left to the body.
He's had success, hasn't he, Walsh, with the uppercuts in both stances. A little bit of defensive work there from Walsh.
You heard Peter Harrison between rounds telling Scott to keep on throwing the jab, and when he gets inside, throw more, let the combinations go.
Well, I think definitely when Walsh changes the southpaw, Harrison should double up with the right hand. Walsh likes to slip down with the first shot, but he won't be able to evade the second shot. A good jumping in hook there from Walsh. And some good defensive moves as well there, John.
Oh, that's a big right hand from Harrison, and another one. And then the uppercut from Walsh, and a good body shot. And the action is really heating up here in round four.
Both landing with heavy shots there, John. I think Harrison's carried the more weight. But Walsh, again, as we know, fighting back brave.
Harrison coming on strong. A bit of swelling just around the right eye of Scott Harrison.
And Walsh there just missing, but again with that uppercut by a whisker.
Solid left-hand lead from Liam Walsh. Quality shot. got his twin brother Ryan, elder brother Michael at ringside, of course, both pros themselves. Scott Harrison, I don't know, put his work in the gym. Look at the shape of it.
Well, he's in tremendous shape, isn't he? And so strong, but he always was, wasn't he? Whatever weight he's at, he's always going to be strong. But Walsh is up to the task, isn't he? Brave and strong himself. Deceivingly strong, to be honest. Because the shots that Harrison hit Walsh in earlier in the round were definitely shots that would put most people down. And that's what Harrison needs, and he needs to get that right hand into play more often. That's the shot that's he's having success with, the shot that's working for him.
Good round, and that was the exchange of the fight so far earlier in that fourth round. Harrison, for me, got the better of it. That's that right hand from Harrison, and another one. And then back came Walsh with that uppercut.
Yeah, that uppercut has got him out of jail a few times in this fight, hasn't it? But definitely there, he looked... Well, to be honest, I was going to say he looked shaken, but he took it very well, didn't he? Really did.
Who do you give the round to?
I couldn't split him, John. I was really sat on the fence.
I'm giving it the old guy. Good round, though.
It was.
Both of them tremendously committed. And it's one of those rounds where, if you're watching at home, that's that uppercut. What a good shot. If you're watching at home, you'll have your own idea. And it's often rounds like that, tight ones, which can decide the course of a contest.
Yeah, most definitely. And I think, you know, in that big exchange, Harrison definitely had the better of that. But I think later on that round then, I think just Walsh was picking up the points a little bit more to even it up in my eyes. But it's still a close fight, isn't it? All to play for.
Back in 2005 that Scott Harrison had his last title fight. 8 years later here, trying to find that magic once more. And Liam Walsh in front of him, maybe just edging this at the moment, but there's not a lot in it. Just ahead on Barry's card, but it might be that Harrison, as he comes forward, is catching the eye with his aggression.
Oh, good heavy right hand again there from Harrison. Just lacks that little bit of snap, doesn't it? But it's heavy, and a tiring shot takes a lot out of you when you land with them over the top. Good left hook to the body there as well from Harrison.
There was talk of Scott Harrison possibly fighting Ricky Burns at one stage. I guess politically that might become an interesting one to try and make now, but I can bet your bottom dollar that Ricky will be watching here right now.
Good right hand there from Walsh. But just when the round's starting to get away from him, he does something to put himself back in the mix.
Scottish fighter John Thain in the background there, just in front of the red barrier. He was in action earlier on, had a slightly controversial points victory against the southpaw Ryan Toms. Got the verdict, but I don't think Toms fans were too impressed by it. And the fighter himself, John Thain, I think, realised he was a little bit fortunate to get the verdict. Harrison bossing this one.
Yeah, he is. Yeah, he just, like I said, he methodically goes about his work, doesn't he? Just keeps throwing punches all the time. And Walsh trying to work back, but Walsh taking too many breathers, I think. Good body shot, though.
At his best, Scott Harrison was special. Oh, there's a good body shot from Walsh. And he's coming back strongly. I remember when Scott Harrison fought Wayne McCulloch. I mean, he was terrific that night.
Yeah, he's been in some great fights, haven't he? We forget he beat Tracy Harris-Patterson in like his 11th fight or something ridiculous like that, wasn't it?
Beat Tom Johnson, Steve Robinson, Medina, you know, I mean, the list goes on, doesn't it? This is a tough fight. This is a strong man's contest. They're really trying to deliver these punches with intent and digging them in.
Well, this is where Harrison certainly wants it.
Referee is... Am I the only person who's getting slightly irritated by this ref?
Yeah, there's no... Okay, maybe that push was called for to be questioned, but all the other work, just let him work. No one's trying to hold. No one's doing anything illegal.
Exactly. As one Lancastrian used to say, it's into tickling contest. Just let it get on. Harrison's round for me, that one.
Yeah, definitely for me. Really was. Like I say, just goes about his work, doesn't he? Just didn't stop throwing punches. Nothing fast in his work, but...
Good work this from Harrison. Really unloading. Look at it, the way he wants it.
But then just when you think that he's taking control, Walsh comes back, doesn't he, with an uppercut or that body shot. That I think that hurt Harrison. There's the uppercut.
It was the
again.
Left hand, wasn't it, that hurt him?
Yeah, and then he played that uppercut, got that uppercut in again, which has worked for him throughout the fight so far.
Brother Michael knew straight away. He was the guy in the black vest on the far side who had his arms in the air.
Well, Liam Walsh knew, because he tried to land it consistently after that, didn't he? Really went for that left hook to the body.
Well, what a good fight this is turning out to be.
Round six.
Might be too much to hope that Scott Harrison was going to be quite the fighter of old, but at this stage, he's giving Liam Walsh plenty to think about. 12 rounder, and we're only in the sixth.
Well, you feel this fight's going to go down to a war of attrition, don't you? Both landed with heavy shots, John.
You could see Harrison talking to himself, or maybe to his opponent. I think he was angry that he'd been suckered in and caught out of that switch-hitting southpaw stance. I beg your pardon, I think I said it was a 12-rounder, this is a 10-rounder.
Yeah, the fact that it's a title fight, you just automatically think it's a 12-rounder, don't you? Same recipe as before in this round. Harrison just trying to stalk down Walsh, trying to trap him on the ropes in the corner, but Walsh being quite fleet-footed. And a few more feints in his work there. He's fainting with his feet, which is good.
Referee telling him to shut up. Bit of chat between the pair of them.
Well, one's from Norfolk, one's from Glasgow. Will they understand each other? Says the Welshman.
You took the words out of my mouth. I was going to say, said the Swansea analyst. Cardiff analyst, I beg your pardon. I thought he was going to hit me then.
Back to the fight, John. Oh, lovely shot there by Walsh.
Enzo Macronelli in action tonight. We've got a fair few Welshmen around the place.
Again, both look at the stalk, looking to counter each other. Not much really going on in this round.
No, it's been a quiet one. It's a bit of a chess match this round, isn't it?
But I think that suits Walsh, yeah. I would think. With the cleaner boxing skills, the fleet-footed, faster hands.
He has Harrison struggling a bit when he switches to southpaw, doesn't he? Just seems a little bit tentative, a little bit hesitant when he's coming out of that stance. And you see the smile on Walsh's face now as he just spears him out of that southpaw stance.
And what he should do, when Walsh switches, he should put that left foot on the outside, jump on him, double up with that back right hand. Harrison.
Well, Harrison's letting this round slip away. Can't give that one to the Scotsman.
No, not much done by either fighter, but Walsh, again, bossing that with his better boxing skills.
Listen, important. If you move
so
you're
giving that one to Walsh. How did he score the fifth?
A little jab he keeps on.
I scored the fifth to Harrison. Quite clearly, I think, as well.
Keep your feet in and out of range.
So you've got it 3-2 with one even at the moment.
Yeah, to play for, John. Hold the play for.
Now, come on. That's what we should do.
Only an hour left of Freeview. If you want to see all the big action later on, remember to register on boxnation.com.
Concentrate on what you're doing.
Yeah. Amir Khan in action, of course, next week from Sheffield. We're all heading up to Sheffield for that one. And then the week after that, it's the big one from the United States, Floyd Mayweather.
Are we going to see it again? Let's see another round.
Round 7. 4 rounds to go.
And for me, no, I think Harrison has to really put his foot on the gas, take a few risks of going forward. But he's not really a fighter, is he, known to go through the gears, to change the pace. He's, you know, he goes about his work and he's effective at it.
That's a better from Harrison. Walsh wanting to hold on. And Peter Harrison shouting his encouragement to his son, wanting him to keep the pressure on.
Well, this is where he needs to jump on him, isn't he? Just changed the southpaw now, Walsh.
This is where Walsh looks more effective out of that southpaw stance for me.
Yeah, landed some good body shots there as well, didn't he?
Harrison blowing now. And he's marking up around that left eye. He's starting to get more bruised and battered.
Yeah, it just seems to be running out of ideas, isn't he, at the moment, Scott Harrison.
Walsh certainly looks the fresher.
Well, the Harrison of a few years ago would have cut the ring off, you know, quite efficient, and he's just following Walsh around. His feet are just a little bit slower than they used to be.
Speared again and again by that jab, and the left eye swelling up all the time of Harrison.
You got to be careful, Walsh. You know, he's having a lot of success. He feels comfortable in it, I understand that, but a risky game dropping your hands in front of Scott Harrison.
Never been really a big one-punch man, though, has he, Harrison? It's more been done by attrition, even when he was in his prime.
Yeah, he's heavy-handed. He doesn't have much snap in his shots, does he? But he's heavy, very, very heavy-handed. You're right, he wears you down, then he beats you up.
Well, he keeps on coming, keeps trying to cut Walsh off, get inside, but somehow the punches aren't quite flowing now as they did earlier on. Referee having a word with Harrison about punching after the break, after the call for break.
And that uppercut to finish the round there for Walsh.
Hard round, tough round. Walsh taking it?
Yeah, for me, John, definitely. Just think Harrison couldn't close the gap quick enough to let his hands go.
He's staying off me. I know he's staying off me. You've got to get in closer, okay?
You want me to do that?
Aye.
So into the eighth of a 10 rounder for the WBO European lightweight title. We've got Liam Walsh ahead now in the red and white shorts, a 26-year-old from Cromer. Good footwork again from Walsh. Thudding body shot as well. Now this is where Harrison wants him, but just can't get the punches off. Bit of illegal use of the head.
again, a good what maybe they call a little check hook there from Liam Walsh. He's been spinning off that hook lovely tonight, hasn't he? Both sides, southpaw and orthodox. That's good work from Walsh. Nice feinting.
Harrison feeling the pace now, unquestionably. And also the accumulative effect of Walsh's punches.
He just can't close the gap quick enough, can he, Harrison? When he gets close, he works away well.
Starting to look as though it's not going to be for Scott Harrison.
Walsh boxing very well, isn't he? Setting up the attacks as well. See, looks comfortable, doesn't he, under pressure as well? No.
Quality body shot. Nice right hand from Walsh.
Nice little left hook there, though, from Harrison. You won't stop trying, though, John.
Well, the boxing ring is where Scott Harrison feels he belongs, even now at the age of 35.
Good body shot again there from Walsh.
Blood now oozing from the nose of the Scotsman. And Walsh is starting to tee off.
It just started with a left hook, didn't it, then, just before that 1-2 combination. Oh, beautiful work.
Well, he's had moments when he's looked uncomfortable here, but that was always going to be likely against somebody as experienced and as strong as Scott Harrison. But here in the eighth round, he looks as though he's bossed that one. He looks as though he's got another cut, I think. Liam Walsh, there we are, and it's not a good one. That is not nice. Mick Williamson straight on the job. It happened towards the end of the round. I couldn't see whether it was a punch or a clash of heads again.
I'm not sure if that's the same one that's opened up, John, just above the
is
right
it just got worse?
Just the corner. Yeah, I think so, yeah. But what surprised me with Walsh... What surprised me with Walsh is that he's been comfortable in close range. He's been, you know, he's coped with the pressure of Harrison and almost tried to push Harrison back, and I never thought I would see that.
It's good from Walsh. Good variety of punch. Taking real joy in his work as well.
These last few rounds he's flowed, hasn't he? Really enjoyed himself, you could see it.
That cut definitely has worsened.
Yeah.
Which is what led to the thought that it might be a second one.
Round nine.
Williamson straight on the case again. And two rounds to go. Two rounds for Scott Harrison to somehow find something huge here to turn this one around. Walsh looks now firmly in control.
Yeah, Harrison has to really force the fight now, doesn't he? But he came out after he two good solid jabs from Walsh straight away.
Could you give that eighth round to Walsh?
Oh yeah, without a doubt, John. I think that was a clear and a good round for him, for Liam Walsh.
You've given him rounds three and five. Two was close.
Yeah, two was very close.
Here's the desire and the willpower of Harrison. Strong man, hard man.
Working away well, isn't he, Harrison? But his punches lack that little bit of bite that they had earlier on in the fight. Just seems to be working away on instinct, though, doesn't he, Scott Harrison?
Walsh is a sharp puncher himself, which shows just what a good chin Harrison still has.
And he's been up to the task in every department, every quarter, hasn't he, really, Walsh? You know, he looks the much... Well, Harrison looks 10 times as strong, doesn't he? But he's really held his own in there, up close. Oh, Lovely work there from Walsh. Uppercut and then two right hands over the top.
Harrison looks as though he's just about all in now.
That hurt him again, that right hand. Right on the button there from Liam Walsh. And Harrison just can't get out of the way, can he, of the shots?
And he's bravely coming forward, still winging in the hooks, Harrison. Still hoping that he might find something to make Liam Walsh unravel.
But he's still landing his shots, isn't he, to be fair to him, but all the quality is definitely coming from Liam Walsh. So the right, good right hand there again from Walt Harrison, but then Walsh comes back with uppercut again. He looks in trouble for me, John. Harrison.
Yeah, I thought he was running out of gas a minute or so ago, and he certainly is doing now in the closing stages of this ninth round. It might be that Walsh is looking to take him out right here and now in the last few seconds of this ninth round. Harrison now is having to trade on bravery. Walsh is going looking for him. Big right hand from Walsh. Harrison on unsteady legs. He might be about to go here. The bell comes. Somehow Harrison sees it through. Somehow he falls heavily back onto his stool. And surely now you're looking at the face of a man who is facing defeat.
How brave is Scott Harrison? Some of the shots he took there and the body shots he took the wind right out of him, but he still kept going. And there was the first shot there, I think, John. Took the wind out of him. And obviously when you weaken to the body, it weakens your chin also. And Harrison had to use all of his renowned resilience just to stay on his feet.
He's starting to get a hiding in there.
Well, it's the accuracy as well, isn't it, of Liam Walsh's shots. He hits you on the button every time. He's hitting them in the solar plexus. Harrison, how did he get through that round? He looked really, really in trouble.
Just shed with him.
And most of the advice before there, when you're watching the replays, was coming from Jimmy Tibbs, just telling Harrison to box and to jab with him. Don't just walk in there and absorb the shots.
But to be honest, you would think that Harrison has to go for broke now, wouldn't you? But he's just going to be walking into punches. You can't really see how he can turn his fight around now. And Walsh looks so sharp still, doesn't he?
I think it's just a question now as to whether Harrison gets through to the final bell. And an obvious question is going to be after this, whether it, for Scott Harrison, if he is to be defeated here, whether it might be the end of the road.
Yeah, well, to Harrison's credit, the class that he has, that he's always going to see, he's still landing his shots now, but you know, he's struggling for pace now, and Walsh is landing with all the cleaner, classier shots.
For four or five rounds, he made it a very, very competitive fight, and you thought that somehow, despite all the years and all the problems, that somehow he's going to round the clock, wind the clock back. But in the second half of the fight, well, there's only been one man really bossing it.
Well, listen, John, time catches up with everyone, doesn't it? And, you know, I just think Liam Walsh is a boxer in the ascendant at the moment. He's looking really good. You know, he's showing his true potential now, of potential world class. And Harrison, you know, obviously, you know, time's caught up with him and just lost a half a pace, hasn't he? And it's made a big difference in this round, in this fight, I should say.
Well, he's still bravely coming forward.
But the strength of Walsh and also the movement, you know, the spinning, the hooking and then spinning off the hook.
You've got to give credit for Liam Walsh. This has been a tough night for him, a difficult night, and he's done what's necessary. Harrison really tried to put it on him in those opening rounds.
Well, I thought Walsh would be really on his bike for most of the fight, you know, fainting a lot, dancing around, but he hasn't, has he? He stood his ground, tried to match Harrison with work. Good work there, though, from Harrison.
Flurry of attack from Harrison.
We've seen it in the last one, didn't he? The punches have lost that little bit of snap now, and just got trying to pushing his arms out, isn't he? Tired figure.
Well, the faces of the two fighters tell their own story. Apart from the cut, Walsh not particularly marked up. Harrison, well, his face is not going to look pretty tomorrow morning.
No, but, you know, you just tend to think, well, would Harrison of 7 or 8 years ago would have been a different fight altogether, possibly.
7 or 8 years ago, I guess the fight wouldn't have happened because Scott Harrison was fighting at featherweight, but I take what you're saying, you know, it's just the strength and the insistence of Harrison then might have made it different. Well, there's the final bell. And I think that Scott Harrison knows, owns his arms aloft, but I think it's just a final salute to the crowd. Surely he can't think that he's won that one, Barry.
No. You know, the first few rounds were pretty touch and go, were close, but for round five onwards, no, I think he won round five. Then from round six onwards, it was all Liam Walsh, who boxed absolutely superb.
Well, you've got it 7-2 with one level.
Yeah. And I think a couple of them could maybe go towards Harrison, but not enough for me for him to win the fight.
Liam Walsh being congratulated by his brothers. And a little pat on the shoulder as well for Mick Williamson, who for the upteenth time has done just a cracking job for his fighter.
Yeah.
Nasty cut, and he kept him in there, no problem.
It did, from the first round as well, wasn't it?
Liam Walsh saluting his supporters who've made their way down from Norfolk. They know. Scott Harrison waves to the crowd, and now he's getting a very much more sporting acclaim from the crowd than he did when he came in. They know that he's been through a lot, and they also know that at his best he was a very, very good fighter indeed. Good to see the two of them now exchanging pleasantries rather than hostilities.
It's been a good fight, hasn't it? It was an honest fight, wasn't it? No malice there. No malice. Harrison came out like a lunatic in the first round. I mean, there was no cheating, no holding, all just trying to work. And they were a credit tonight. Both of them boxed really well.
Hard guy, Scott Harrison. But for me, just too many miles on the clock. And in a moment, we can get the verdict. It's Mark Burdis.
Okay, after 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecard. And we have a unanimous decision. Judge Zoltan Anyidi scored the contest 98-92. Denny Nelson 97-93. Mark Nelson 97-93. The winner. And still the WBO European lightweight champion in the blue corner from Cromer, Liam Walsh.
Scott Harrison shakes his head a little disconsolately, and he'll have, I suppose, tonight some hard questions to ask about himself, whether or not he can believe that he wants to go on in this business. He's been a terrific fighter in years gone by, and maybe we shouldn't really remember him for tonight. Perhaps we should remember him for his achievements all those years ago. For now, the winner, and the emphatic winner, was this man. He did what was necessary, and still the champion, Liam Walsh.
Thank you very much indeed, John. Yeah, Liam Walsh would have learned a heck of a lot in that fight. And Scott Harrison, the former world champion, well, what a fighting heart he has got, what fighting instincts he has got, going right the way through to the end. And if he does go out tonight, he will definitely have gone out on his shield. But this fellow, aged 25, has got his fighting career ahead of him. Age 26, took a year off his age there. He won't mind about that, I'm sure. Okay, let's get the verdict of these two guys. Billy Joe Saunders, British and Commonwealth middleweight champion. Steve Lillis, Box Nation's expert analysis. Go on, you go first, Steve, on that one.
Yeah, I fought it a bit closer than the judges. I only had a couple rounds in the end.
You?
But obviously, had Walsh winning. I thought it was a tremendous effort from Scott. You know, John said in commentary, you know, you won't remember him by tonight. You think you can remember what he did tonight.
But I agree with you on that.
What he's been through in life, his drink problems, you know, he's been in jail, in a Spanish jail for 2.5 years. To come back after 7 years, this is 7 years since his last big fight. You know, he's had 2 six-rounders. To come in with that performance tonight was pretty special, and all credit to Scott. But, you know, it's a young man's sport, isn't it? And that's what we saw tonight.
I had it 98-92, agreed with one of the judges for what that is worth, by the way. You thought it was going to be a pretty comfortable night for Liam. It was perhaps a bit harder than you anticipated.
Yeah, it was. looked and I saw the shape of him, I mean, you could see Harrison was in good shape. It surprised me, to be honest. I mean, with his name and that. But when I saw the shape of him, it shocked me. But I think Liam Walsh could have made it a little bit easier for himself, but he showed up and come in fighter.
This is the ninth where he took everything here, Scott, and came firing right back, Billy Joe.
Yeah, I mean, as you can see there, look, Liam Walsh standing toe-to-toe with him, just showing him, like, I'm boss, I'm the new person on the block sort of thing, you know. He's got a lot of proving to do now, Liam, with Ricky Burns, you know, out of Frank Stable and that. So he's fighting for his number one spot at his weight, and I think that, you know, he's on the right path. But 97-93, I'll give it to him, and a clear winner for me.
Absolutely.
Boxed very well.
And he used that uppercut to great effect, did Liam Walsh there, and he probably lasted a bit better down the stretch, which, given he's 9 years younger, that is no great surprise. And terrific camaraderie between the fighters at the end, and I'm sure we'll see great camaraderie now as they both talk to Alex.
Yeah, exactly. Liam just said, I wouldn't have liked to have fought him 10 years ago. That was hard work, wasn't it? Yeah,
very hard work. I love Sly said from Don't Want You to Watch Scott 10 years ago, and I used to admire him. He is the winner anyway. Look at the shape he's in, and the, you know, where he is in his life now. You know, I got massive respect for Scott. That's all I can say. Massive respect for him.
You look
great, warrior. Tough. Oh, in the word, and then come back at me, and he's talking to me in there as well. He's saying, come on. And it was admirable. It was brilliant.
It really was up for grabs, certainly through the first five rounds. You gave it absolutely everything. What was the difference tonight, do you think?
I thought it was a very close fight. Liam Walsh is a brilliant fighter. Big respect to him. He's undefeated. He was 14. I thought it was a very close fight. It was a good fight for the fans.
It was a great fight for the fans.
I felt the first half of the fight, it was pushing forward. And I felt Liam started boxing, moving a bit more. Kind of a wee bit more cagey, and that was one good fight.
It looked like the way you responded to the fans at the end of the fight, that looked like a farewell. That's what people will be asking now.
No, I don't see that. Do you think I should be gone?
No, I'm not saying that, but people will be asking that.
No, they are. No, I said I'll come back, not just for one night, or not just for a payday or anything like that. I love boxing. I come for a fighting family. I'm fighting all my days. Love boxing in front of the fans. I fight for my family. I like to get Stacey, my fiance, big shout out, my three kids. Him soon tomorrow.
Yeah, you made them proud.
It was a good night. I look forward to the future.
You made them.
And I wish them all the best.
Well, he's got a big, big future. Obviously, Ricky Burns was in the work before the car crash. Would you take that again if you got it? What next?
Straight away, but this is your man to talk to. I think Alex. Whatever Francis can come up with.
Let's bring Francis Warren in. That was great to watch, first of all.
It's a cracking fight. We know we made the fight that was going to excite the fans both here and at home on Box Nation, and it didn't crowd disappoint. I thought Liam, after having a bit of a difficult year last year, actually a very difficult year last year with his injury, performed fantastically well against a guy who's still got flashes of brilliance from his heyday. Scott's problems have been well documented, but again, I've got to give Scott a lot of credit for the way he performed, especially in the first five rounds.
All those days scrapping with the brothers in the front room's been worth it, hasn't it?
Yeah, every single day has been worth it, yeah. These two are me everything, as I am theirs, and that's what gets us through all the time. We fight for everyone, we fight for our families, and the fans as well. Just want to say a massive thank you to you all, you're different class always, and I hope I've done you proud.
Very quick word from Francis.
But you're saying about that, the Ricky Burns fight, would enhance Liam's ranking in the WBO further. So, Liam said he'd take it at a heartbeat, and I think, before the year is out, he'll be fighting for a world title.
Boys, family, Scott, well done. Thanks very much.